Working with GA4 data in BigQuery can be a real pain, even for SQL experts. Fortunately, there is a zero coding solution called GA4 SQL built by Optimization Up. With just clicks, you can build instant reports for BigQuery so you can save time and focus on insights instead. Let's see how. Again, right now we are focusing only on querying Google Analytics for data. If you need general SQL queries or conduct analysis, we've got you covered in another video. There, we walk you through the process of accessing and starting a project in BigQuery and show you how to effectively ask ChatGPT for the answers you need. In fact, we suggest you to use both tools, like GA4 SQL for querying and ChatGPT for analysis. So make sure to check that out. To use the tool, head over to ga4sql.com. We are going to cover live examples, but first, let's have a quick overview of the interface. Make sure to select Google Analytics 4. For your table name, you can add a new table ID, which can be fetched from your BigQuery details section. You can select date ranges. You also have custom date range. To query your metrics or dimensions, simply click on their respective bar and select your metric, and do the same for dimensions. You can always hover the interrogation mark to know what the dimension or metric is all about. Another interesting feature are filters, which allows you to filter your data based on the dimension and metric that you have added in. You can also sort your data by ascending or descending order. And lastly, you can also fetch your custom dimensions. Then you'll have to click on the Generate Query button and the code will appear here. Copy the code and go and paste it into BigQuery. Let's begin with a simple query. For this, we'll be using the BigQuery sample dataset for GA4, assuming that you already have a BigQuery project. If not, please refer to our other video. In your BigQuery project, select your table. Go to Details. Hover over your table ID and copy your table ID. In GA4 SQL, paste your table ID in table name. To avoid any conflict with your date range selections, select your date and delete it. Now we'll select the date. You can look at the date range available for your dataset right here. We'll select the custom date range. And I'll look at the year 2020, starting from the 1st of December to the last month of January 2021. When it comes to our dimensions and metrics, I'm interested in looking at our number of sessions for each of our events. Click on Metrics. Select Sessions. In Dimension, search for Event Name. And that will be it for now. Generate your query. Here's your code. Copy your code. Now let's compose a new query. And we'll go in New Tab. I'll delete this. And let's paste our code. Always make sure to look here at the top right side for the size of your query to make sure to keep your cost down. Now, we are not dealing with gigabytes, so we'll be fine. And again, this is just best practice because right now we are dealing with a public dataset and we will incur no costs. Let's run our query. And here we have our list of event names and their number of sessions. For our next example, I'm interested in recreating the landing page report and we'll keep our current top settings. For metrics, let's add in sessions, engage sessions. I'm also interested in the average engagement time per user. Let's also add our page views. We'll also add in our total users, our number of new users, and lastly, also our total revenue. For the dimension, let's use the landing page dimension. You also have the option of reordering your metrics. Let's start with page views, then after our engage sessions, we look at the number of total users, then our number of new users, and this should be fine. Let's generate our query. Copy your code and paste it into BigQuery. Let's run our code. And here's our landing page report. Now I'd like to order our landing page report by our number of page views. For this, we can go to Sort By, let's select our field, Screen Page Views, and select Descending Order. Let's regenerate our query. Now our landing page report is sorted by our screen page views. I'd like to take this a step further by focusing only on the landing pages receiving traffic from our advertising campaigns. Let's add our session source medium dimension. And now that we've selected it, we can filter it to look only at CPC. Generate the query and copy your code. Again, please pay attention to this message. Our query is processing right now around 1000 megabytes, which equates to about 1 gigabyte. And 1 gigabyte is still within the free tier. Again, don't worry because we are using a free BigQuery public dataset, so no matter what, you'll not pay anything. This is just to instill best practices so you don't make mistakes when querying your company's data. Let's run our query. And here we have our results with our landing pages filtered by our traffic coming from our advertising campaigns with Google CPC. Lastly, let's look at some ways that we can limit our costs. And this will be a great opportunity for us to look at how to use ChatGPT in combination with GA4 SQL. Two ways we can limit our cost is first, to look at shorter date ranges. And also, if you look at our results, we can also limit costs by limiting the number of columns that we have in our results, not rows. So in this example, we have the session source medium column. I'd like to keep the session source medium filter, but drop the column in our end results. To limit our date ranges, we could go to GA4 SQL and change our date ranges, but I would like to just run everything with ChatGPT. After copying and pasting our code, I asked ChatGPT to drop the session source medium column in the end results and show data only for the month of January 2021. ChatGPT returned me a solution. Let's copy the code and let's paste this in BigQuery. And you can see that we've went from 1000 megabytes or 1 gigabyte down to 396 megabytes. Let's run the query. And here are our results. Alright, we come to the conclusion of this video and we hope that you found it useful. Please share your thoughts with us and see you next time.